Speaker tonight will be is a very, very special person. He's been spiritually guiding each and every Filipino, and I guess it's our privilege also to hear and listen to some words of thanks from Father Reuter.
The remarkable thing about Supreme Master Ching Hai is that she reaches out to those who are in need all over the world. And here in the Philippines, she has extended a very substantial help to our Aitas who were dislocated by the eruption of Pinatubo. She was very touched by the fact that so many of them were killed and so many of them were driven from their homes, were homeless and without any support, that she contributed very strongly to our efforts to help those people. We now have a real community of Itas in Zambales, and it is doing very, very well. We have education going on and livelihood, and they are going to school. So we are helping those Itas very, very strongly through the assistance of Supreme Master Ching Hai. So we are deeply grateful to her for that. Thank you very much.
Before everything begins, let us close our eyes for a while and pray for this country and her people. We pray that the land will be happier and happier every day, and her people will be quickly experience the bliss of heaven according to his will. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, my Lord. Thank you for your love. I feel so much love from the Philippine people. It's very difficult to explain. So much love from these people. May the Lord bless you more and more every day. It's been a long time since I visited your beautiful country. I have almost forgotten how beautiful the people are. How are you? It's a little hard for you there. Are you all right? Comfortable? Yes. Yes. I'm sorry, my people did not expect such a overwhelming crowd, so they have probably rented a small place. So you don't have enough comfortable seat. My deep apology. But you have a seat in my heart. Always. Always. Because of all the kindness that you have showered upon the weak and needy people, although this country has not always been fortunate as the way we would have wished to have, the way we would have wished to be. But then that is the mark of the generosity and kindness. Because if we give and if we are kind in only when we are in fortunate situation or only when we are rich and wealthy and comfortable, then it is not so much of a surprise. Only when we give in our very humble situation and even in the trial situation, then the Lord really knows that we truly are His beloved children, and we bring the love of God to this planet. Blessed be you. You are so great, so loving, so kind, so warm and so generous. And all the trial and tribulations just magnifying all this great quality of the Philippines people. I have met many of you in this land, and it gives me always the best impression that I can remember. I take this opportunity today to thank you again, again and again, for being so good, for being yourself. Thank you. And we have the father here to thank. the mother and Mr. Great Morato. Thank you. And the Senate. And the loving, beautiful couple here, I think you know who they are. Please stand up also. Yes. And many, many more, please. The one who sit in the front here, all the great people, you will come and learn to know them later. I guess you know them better than I do. I'm very honored and very, very happy to come back to this wonderful land, especially to the wonderful people that is very difficult for me to forget. Some people you met and you forget. Some people you met, you never forget. The Philippine people make people never forget. Not only myself, the Philippine people abroad also give very, very good name to this nation. I just want you to have this feedback because I travel a lot. And I saw many Philippine people abroad, and they always give very, very good representation to their country. Now, if we as human beings give also such a good representation about our Father in heaven, then it would be very good for our planet. It's not always that every person can represent God in such a heavenly way. It's not because they don't want to, just because they have forgotten the kingdom of God, which is within ourselves. The Bible has mentioned very, very clearly, Jesus said again and again, "Know you not that you are the temple of God, and the Holy Spirit dwells within you?" We read the Bible every day. And we heard Jesus say that we are the children of God. It's just that very difficult for us to remember this. In order to remember where we came from, we have to go back there. We have to return step by step, tracing back to the kingdom where we have really the origin of our being. Because we are not human. We are not this physical body which is called human. We are from heaven. All of us, even the worst sinners that we think that they are the worst sinners, they are also from heaven. The reason they sin is just because they are frustrated here. In their deepest memory of the subconscious, they remember what heaven is like. They remember the freedom, the abundance, the richness, the mighty power that they have when they were with the Father. And when we came here to this planet and encased in this physical body, we feel very, very restricted. That's why children cry, the babies cry the first moment they came here. If it should be a happy place, they would smile when they were born. It is because when the baby was first born, they were still very much in contact with God power, very much in contact with the Father in heaven. So when they contact with this very coarse and suffering world, they feel immediate pain, and they cannot bear it, so they cry. And slowly, this memory of heaven fades. The older we grow, the memories of our origin will be faded from us. It has the reason, so that we can continue in this physical life without feeling too much homesick. We have to do whatever we do here. So God has arranged that we forget our origin, but only for a while. Up to the age of 4 or 5, the children still remember where they came from, still contact with heaven. That's why they are so pure, so happy. Doesn't matter in which circumstance, their eyes sparks with love and with the heavenly bliss that we adults have lost. The older we became, the spark in our eyes faded more and more, because we have contacted with this physical world, which is very coarse, which is not refined, which is not blissful compared to where we came from. We came here for different reasons. We came here so that we can know God. Even if our purpose in life is different, our reason to come here is different, the way of living is different, but the only one goal for coming here is so that we can recognize God. It sounds paradox, but it is like that. It has been explained to me. I have seen in the inside vision why it is like that. It is because we have been in heaven with the Father all this eternity. We were one with the Creator. We are with Him, with her all the time. So we cannot know what it is. So we need a reflection of all this glory, the one that is not the real one, so that we can know the real one. Just like we need the mirror to see our true self, our face. The mirror is only an image, just a reflection. It's not real. But because of the mirror, we can know ourselves. Similarly, this world is just an illusion. It's just a mirage, just a reflection of the true world, of Godhood. But we need it so that we do know what God is like. Therefore, the Bible says to us that judge not, because you will be judged. Why should we not judge our brothers and sisters? Because they are God's children also. They are the same essence as God. We are all children of God. So no matter what he does, he is God inside. He has God inside him. And he came here to do this and that and others in order for him to know God. The way we have chosen so that we can know God is different. Some choose a very moral way so they get to know God quicker. Some choose a longer and harder way by being less moral, by being less noble, less good, so that he can learn to know God in a more intense way. But of course, in our human standard, we have value good and bad, moral and immoral. So therefore, we have judgment. We have come to make a definition about good and bad, evil, and so forth. But in the eyes of our Father, we are all equal, because everything here is an illusion anyway. Bad or good is not real. It's just a reflection so that we know God in the totality of it. Because we have been in heaven for so long, everything is so good, so pure, so perfect. So we cannot know the perfection unless we see the imperfection. We cannot realize a man unless we have a woman to compare. We cannot know goodness unless we have something bad in contrast to it. And that's why we came here into this world of the physical dimension, so that we can know the worst of the suffering, of the pain, of the sorrow. So then we can know goodness, we can know glory, we can know bliss, we can know blessing of heaven. That's why we have to know God in this lifetime. We must see him. We must not just talk about him. We must not just hear about him. We must not just understand about him. We must see him or her, if it's a her or a him, whoever. We don't argue about that. God is not like has to have a gender. God is an almighty power, all loving, all kindness, all forgiving. So if any of us here, like the Philippine people, have more of this quality, you are very near to God. From inside, you must have very, very deep faith, very deep desire to know the Father. And that's why you people are so pure, so kind, and so warm. But we could go a step further, like we can see the Father for ourselves. We can see the true God that dwells within this temple. And that is the only way that makes us completely happy in this world and the world beyond. Because that's what we came here for, to see the reflection, to see the illusion, so that we know the reality, to see all the bad, all the ephemeral nature, all the pain and suffering, so that we can know God, which is in heaven, which is all good, all glory, all blissful, all happiness, and all eternal. to know God. We cannot just talk like this. Talking about candies is not a candy. So in order to know a candy, we have to eat it. In order to know God, we have to go within, where Jesus mentioned that the kingdom of God is within you. Within you. So I'm going to show you the within kingdom, so that you can see for yourself that we are not human beings. We are not this mortal body. God lives within us. And when God lives within us, we are just a part of God. We are one with God. We are not a normal, mortal, sentient being. If we see this for ourselves, then we truly understand the Bible. When Jesus mentioned the kingdom of God is within you, then we can see it to ourselves. What is it like, this kingdom of God within us, when we see it? We see some of the experiences that the past saints have while they were in communion with God. For example, like St. John, he hears the trumpet of the heaven. Like Moses, he sees God appear like a flame, big flame of light. And he hears God speaking to him with the sound like the thunder, the sound of many water, etc., etc. These experiences, which are recorded in the Bibles, are the real thing. It's not a mysterious thing that only happened to the saints in the past. It is real. It still can happen to us today, to any of us here, because we are all children of God. We are all part of this. We are not this body. Therefore, any time we want to go within to see the kingdom, we can see it. It's just we don't. We normally see candy, see flowers, see people, see work, see money, see cars, see traffic, see the sun, the moon outside. But we don't ever try to go inside, which is a completely different world, which is a true world. That is what it means in the Bible, like the kingdom of God within you. The kingdom of God within is full of glory, full of light, which is brighter than 10,000 suns of this planet. But it doesn't burn your eyes. It doesn't make you feel uncomfortable. It makes you feel more elated, more light, more wiser, more loving, more kind, more nearer to our original abode, which is God, which we call heaven. The reason why we are unhappy, no matter how much money we have, no matter how high a position we have in the society, because we have forgotten this true kingdom of God. The Bible told us, Jesus told us, don't lay our treasure on this world, in this world, but our true treasure is in heaven. That's what he meant. We must see the treasure inside. Then our lives become better and better all the time, even outside. The treasure from inside will manifest also and make us a different person. Even the outlook different, the thinking different, the health different, the work efficiency different, the intelligence become different, the whole outlook inside out become different. I look different today than maybe 15 years ago. Before enlightenment, that is for sure. I know this from personal experience. Everything I have today is because of the kingdom of God gives me. As a human being, I can never accomplish anything. I was nobody until God has graced my soul with his own love and knowledge. Until God has awakened himself within myself and show me that he's there. That I can always love him, rely on him, call on him. He told me that he's the Supreme Master. And Ching Hai means the ocean of love. It's not my physical name. It is the name of our Father. We can call him also many other different names. It doesn't matter. Just like we call our mother, mom, mommy, anything we call her. But she knows and we know. Yes. If we don't see God truly, if we don't recognize our true self, we can never truly be happy. And at the time of death, because of this undying longing to know ourselves, unfulfilled, we might be in some miserable state for a while, and we might call that hell. But if we know God, we are already happy when we are in the physical body. So when we so-called die, we continue that happiness, and only angels and saints will come to greet us. So we never feel lonely or fearful at the time of death even. The saints in the Bible say that I die daily. So when we are enlightened, we're not afraid of death. We could really die daily and come back to life. How do we do that? We just step back into the kingdom of God inside, leave the body outside like it's dead. It could be like dead. The eyes will turn upward, the body is immobile. And then we just go within the universe inside with the real world and enjoy. And whenever we're ready, we come back, pick up this body again, and then do whatever we have to do left over while we are living in this planet. So this is what it means by dying daily. And we could do that. We could do that. Because we are originally from heaven. This body we just borrow for a while. Just like we live in a hotel, just like we drive a car, so that it is convenient for some different purposes. But our real self is the driver. It's not the car. So anytime the driver can step in, step out of the car, enjoy different things. Similarly, our true self, it's within us. We can come back in, come back out, come back in, come back out. That is the true liberation. It's the true freedom while living. While we still take care of our brothers and sisters and family and job and earning money, discharging our duty on this planet, we still can enjoy heaven whenever we have free time. And when we are so adept at it, we could even do both at the same time. Can clean your teeth and talk to God at the same time. Can wash your dishes and see heaven at the same time. But this needs practice, yes. Enlightenment comes immediately. If you know how to walk back in the kingdom, walk back to where we came from, it came immediately. I can show you that. It's very quick. But the long-term practice will make you more adept. You see, in living, coming and out quickly. Just like beginning, we don't know how to drive the car very well. We need a teacher, and we still drive clumsily. But later on, we can drive while even talking to friends and listening to radio and do all kind of other thinking. In the beginning, when we first learned to drive the car, we had to be very careful. Still, we bump into things. But later on, we drive very fast, and we can even do tricks sometimes. Similarly, long time we inhabit this body, we have forgotten that we could be free of it anytime. Just like you, there is a story about a pilot. It's a true story. He fly airplane, and as a pilot, he often had to overnight on airplane on duty. And he sleep in the kind of the chair, you know, the chair that can recline. It's not the normal bed, but the chair that you recline half like this while he's at work. So he sleep like that a lot of time in his life. So whenever he come home, he can't sleep in a normal bed because he's so used to with sleeping in this kind of, you know, awkward chair, which we couldn't sleep for a long time, but he could, because he gets so used to it that the ordinary flat and comfortable bed become uncomfortable to him. So at home, he has to buy a chair like exactly like the pilot chair and then sleep in it. Can you imagine? Habit can be so binding, can be so powerful, that make us forget everything else. Similarly, we have stuck inside this body for so long, we forgot to leave it. Until the time of death come, and then we're even reluctant to leave it. We cry, we struggle. We don't want to leave the body, which causes so much pain and suffering and work. For this body alone, we work 10 hours a day. We had to do so many things in order to keep this body alive. And when we die, we don't want to leave it even. But the heaven is supremely beautiful. If we know it now, we want to leave the body immediately. We want to leave this world immediately. We don't want to stay here one more second. That's why the saints of the past and present, they never care about dying or not dying. They never care much about the material comfort because they know better life inside. So I'm just going to show you how to remember to step out of the body again. That's it. And then you see heaven immediately. There are only two worlds, the one with the body and the one without the body. The one with the body is the one in this world, the one in the material dimension, the one in the physical atmosphere. The one without the body is the one above this world. Its connection with heaven is omnipresent, is one with the whole universal power, one with heaven. That is what Jesus say, the kingdom of God within. We can learn to step back in there anytime and step out of the body anytime. Immediately, you can learn this tonight. And you practice. The more you practice, the more easier it becomes. Everything has a solution. Everything has a way. There are the way to do things in this world. We learn it with the teacher, with friends. There are the way to do things in heaven. We learn it also with teacher, with friends. Just because we have not learned doesn't mean we cannot do it. Everything we learn, we can do. Especially the thing about heaven, we already know. So it's even easier than any of the physical things that we learn in this world. To learn driving is difficult. To learn even to eat as a kid is difficult. But to learn to go back to heaven is not, because we from there, we already know everything about heaven before we came here. Otherwise, where do you think we came from? If we didn't come from heaven, where do you think we came from? Before we have this physical body, where have we been? Where were we? And who is the we? Who is the we that come into this physical body? And who is the we that left the physical body? That is the real self. That is the oneness with God. That is the essence of our being. And that essence of our being can always leave this body and come back again, anytime. And this is the art, the real living art, the true things that we have forgotten. And that's why we suffer. We have so much pain, frustration, and sorrow. And sometimes we do some things that against our good judgment because we forget our great self. We're just thinking about food, about job, about problems. We forget that we are great. We're so great that all this problem, all this poverty, all this struggling is nothing at all to us. Once we regain our glory, regain our power again, nothing that's matter to us anymore in this physical planet. Even though we still continue to work, it's just child's play to us. Because we know we are great. If the king remember that he is a king, anything else matter to him anymore? No, right? If the king has forgotten he's a king or he has been in exile too long, he's been used to with hardship. But once he remember, once he regain his throne again, anything else would matter to him? Not at all. Not at all. This is a secret of a happy life, now and after. And I'm going to impart it to you. Because God has told me that I have to do this job. There's so many jobs you already do. This job nobody do. He said there's a vacancy. Every other job is already occupied. This job is vacant. He said, okay, I can do that. And you too also can do this job, because we all the same. Just you have forgotten to step in and step out of the kingdom within yourself. I'm going to show you tonight. It's very easy. If you want to, we have time, we stay behind and do this job together. And as you learn to know more and more of the kingdom of God, you'll be more and more happy, wiser and wiser, more loving than the Philippine people already are. You cannot imagine anyone could be more loving like the, more loving than the Philippine people, can you? But can. After you become one with God again, you remember yourself again. You'll be loved without loving. You will give without knowing. You be compassionate without thinking that you are even compassionate. Because God will do everything. We remember God, and God will do everything. And the ego will go, the mind will die. Only God takes charge of everything in our daily life. Every activity, every thought, every word that we spoken will be just from heaven. And that's how we become one with heaven again. And that's the purpose for us to come here. Okay, I have advertised so much about heaven. I think it's enough. And if you have any doubt or question, please let me know. Then we can get over to the real thing, which is stepping back to the kingdom of God, which is as easy as I take this candy from this pocket basket. Because you have it already. It's you inside. I'm not going to give you anything. I'm just going to remind you where to find your forgotten good. That's it. So no need to call me master this and that. These are very kind of people, whoever call me whatever. But we are just brothers and sisters. We are all the same. That's what I know, and that's what you will know. Thank you very much for your patience.
Pinapaalalahanan ko po lahat na dun po sa mga magazine na natanggap natin, may isa pong papel doon na kung may gusto po tayong itanong, pwede po nating isulat at ipasa po dito sa unahan. I reminded the master that we have a questionnaire inserted in booklet, so
right.
They can write their questions and ask you. And we have translators in front if those people who cannot wanted it in Filipino. So.
Oh, they all understand English. No need translation. I know Philippine people, they speak English everywhere.
Okay. So
intelligent race of people.
Yes, we have the first question.
Yes, read it, please.
The question was, how can I conquer all the triumphs in my life? How can I conquer all the triumphs in my life now that I am a Muslim?
Because he's a Muslim?
Yes. He wanted to know how he can conquer all the trials now that he chose to be a Muslim.
The only way to conquer anything in this world or the next is to be yourself, to be your original self, to know the God within yourself again. That's the only answer. Once God takes charge, once God awakens within you, everything else will be taken care of. Seek you first the kingdom of God, and all the things shall be added unto you. That's what it really means. We have only one God, brother and sister, only one God. You name him Christian God, Muslim God, Buddhist God, I don't care. We have only one Father, okay? One.
Okay, another question. They wanted to know what is meditation and how can we meditate and to whom do we meditate?
To whom do we meditate? Okay. To your God self inside. Meditate is a form of the deepest prayer. The prayer that is done in the closet that nobody even knows that you're praying. It's just like you're praying, but very deeply, very quietly, and then we contact God within ourselves, and every question will be answered.
Someone wanted for you to expound. What is the difference between coming in and coming out from the physical to the spiritual body?
Oh, they're two different worlds. Coming out, we see this world. We see everything that is in this physical world. Coming in, we see heaven and whatever that is in heaven. How much of heaven depends on how much concentration. So because some people have more difficult to concentrate than another. Some people are poor, very pure in the heart and very simple, like a child. So when he closes his eyes, he sees great light, he sees heaven right away. He sees Jesus. He might see Buddha, Muhammad, whom the past master. But some people have more difficulty to contact the higher dimension, higher beings. But takes after a while, you all can. Just some people take longer, some people take shorter. But the time, when you do it today, you can see it right away, because I will help you.
Okay, another one from Vanya. She wanted to practice and try the method of meditation, but first she wanted to know if it is necessary that she be initiated first by a master before she can benefit from the method of meditation.
I have just shown you how to meditate right here. It's open. But if you want to know more detail, you let my people know, and we call you later, and I explain more.
With all the details.
Yes, that is the so-called initiation. Actually, God initiates you. I am just giving you some advice or some help when at the beginning, when you have some question, how to sit, how to quiet the mind, how long should I sit, what time should I sit, and where. For example, those small tribal things. The initiation come from God in silence, absolute silence, just between you and him. But we need a little time and a quiet place. We have some quiet room here, and you please let us know your name. I will show you after this. Now, it costs nothing now, costs nothing between, costs nothing ever. Because it's from God, just a gift from God, from yourself to yourself. You don't ever need to oblige anything to me or to anyone.
Okay, are you familiar with the Rosicrucian philosophy?
Oh, yes. Yes, it's just one of the school in the old time. One of the philosophy school of the old time. I know. We had so many masters in the past, and they left a lot of teaching. In order to understand this teaching deeply, we must go inside and get our own wisdom.
How do we cope with the pain that we feel, or when we feel so down and hopeless?
Yes, awaken the God within us, and you have no more fear, pain, or sorrow of any kind. Because God is the all-healer. God is the all-comforter. We have to return to God in order to feel good.
Why are you a vegetarian? Do you consider it a health perspective or in a spiritual way?
Oh, vegetarian is a way of a compassionate way of life, that we respect and love all beings equally. A vegetable, if we cut one branch, it grows three more branches. Okay. But if we cut one head of the pig, he never grow another three heads. So all beings, they are afraid of dying, and we don't want to cause them suffering, hence the vegetarian diet.
In relation to being a vegetarian, is it necessary to be a vegetarian in order to have pure meditation?
A vegetarian does help us to facilitate peaceful and calm while you meditate, because the animals' energies, they interfere. When they're dying, they have very fearful feeling, and they struggle. And these energies still are contained in the meat. And if we meditate, this struggling energy will make us difficult to concentrate. So it is better also for the spiritual progress, quick spiritual progress, that we are vegetarian. Yes.
I am a born-again Christian. I know only one God, Jesus Christ, through the intercession of the Holy Spirit. What would you say about venerating saints?
Oh, wow. I'm not here to judge anyone. I'm here to show you the God within yourselves. Yeah?
Okay.
Thank you.
Do you believe in reincarnation?
Yes and no. Yes and no. Because yes is because we could also re-experience the same life again if we chose to. Because we are with God, we can choose to do anything we want. But mostly, we don't have to. We just progress upwards. Yes.
What is the greatest happiness in this world?
To know God. To know God. That's the greatest happiness in this world. And any world at all.
Is there any relationship between your teaching and that of Indian Radha Swami Group, headed by the Singhs, and the American Enkankar Group, founded by Paul Twitchell? Is this one and the same teaching?
Again, I'm here to show you that you are great. I'm here to show you that your great self. Be hurried to know yourself. There's no need to know anything else except God. If these group people, they teach the same thing and they can show you God, then it is the same. If it's not, then it is not.
Okay, what is in your group's definition of being born again?
Like born again Christian?
Yes, like that. Sorry.
All right, yes. Anytime we feel that we have some great experience happen to us, and that we feel that like our life has been renewed, that perhaps we feel that we are born again. It could happen, yes. It could happen. To the real Christian people, when Jesus was alive, when he gave them initiation, when he baptized them, that's when they are really born again.
Someone wanted to know your view on divorce.
If it's necessary, absolutely necessary, then we divorce. Otherwise, we should stick to one partner and try to work it out and make the family a happy place of refuge.
Someone wanted to know, I want to know where God came from.
Ah, that you have to ask him. Yeah, I can't answer for the Lord. It's his personal thing. I can only bring you to God, and then whatever you ask God, this is your own question.
Okay, not a question, but from Mrs. Julia Oteda, she is highly appreciative of you coming to our country, and she is interested of being one of your disciples, because mostly Filipinos are very, very, very hungry for the words of God. The word God is difficult for them to emphasize and understand. That's why crime happens in the country. And she just wanted to thank you. She sends her greatest thanks, and God bless.
Thank you. God bless you more. The Philippine people are very near to God. Very near to God. Okay. They just look inside and they see God right away. No problem.
Okay, if God really loves humanity, why are there a lot of sufferings?
Oh, suffering because we don't know God. Once we know God, he takes care of everything. The connection has been a little bit, disturbed. If at the time of initiation I try to fix it, just like the car sometimes, engine runs bad. God always takes care of us. The problem is that we don't hear what God say because we have not contact him. Once we go inside, we see God again and we will know better.
Why does God not choose to manifest his power now, not like in the olden days of Moses, where he parted the Dead Sea and Jesus walked on water and brought the dead back to life?
Yes, he still do it. God still does whenever necessary. But we must know. We must know. We must contact God. Then we can see this. We cannot see many things with the physical eyes. We have to see the way of God with the heavenly eye. That's what I'm going to show you so that you know God is really merciful and loving. We cannot see God doing if we don't go within and contact Him. God is doing miracle every day. We don't see it because we only look with the physical eyes.
Okay, how can we open our third eye?
That's my job. I'm going to show you after this.
Someone wanted to know also, are you a prophet or sent by God?
I am only your friend.
Okay.
Yeah? I'm one like you. What I know, you will know.
Do you believe in the second coming of Jesus Christ?
Yes, I do. He came every day. You don't see Him. What a pity. Our people, our initiates, people, they see Him, talk to Him. And He teach us so many great things. You miss them all out because you don't come inside. Jesus never died. You must know. Jesus never died. He just changed the body. He changed and He lives in a different dimension now. He doesn't live in the physical dimension anymore. So if we want to see Him, we have to leave the physical dimension and go to where He resides. Just like if I want to see you, I have to come to the Philippines. I have to take an airplane. Yeah? Similarly, if you want to see Jesus or the past master, great past master again, we have to leave this physical body, ascend into a higher places where our master stays, and we can learn from them great things. You cannot learn much from me because I am stay here with you. I show you how to go to a greater school and learn with a greater teacher. Yeah?
How can a person who has weak faith and when he is always given challenges by God overcome all of these?
Oh, he has to know God again. Every question you ask here come to one answer only. Because we don't know God, we have all these questions. Because we don't know God, we have all these problems.
Okay, how can I search love and mercy?
Know God.
Okay.
Get enlightened. Get initiation.
Could you please define law of karma in life? Law of karma.
The law of karma?
Yes.
Oh. The law of karma is just one that appointed by God who take care of the deeds of the people, like trial and tribulation, what we call, as you sow, so shall you reap. He takes care of that. So if we do some bad thing, we get the bad reward. If we do some good thing, He gives us a good reward. That is the job of the Lord of karma. Karma means retribution.
Okay, another question. Someone wants to know, do you have to transfer from one religion to another to be saved?
No, never. Don't, stay where you are. Be an enlightened Christian, be an enlightened Muslim. Be an enlightened Buddhist. Just stay where you are. All religion is good. We have only one God, I told you. Just misunderstanding, call different name. See, like in Philippines, in English we call mother, and in Chinese they call mother like Mu Jin, Abu. In French they call them La Mère. You see? It's the same.
Okay, for all those who died, who never had a chance to confess their sins, will their souls be saved in heaven?
It depends on what they do in life, you see? If they do good things, heaven will open. If they do bad things, they have to learn to do some better first.
Okay. How does one show that he's sorry for having sinned?
By Jesus tell you, sin no more. Just repent and sin no more and do something on the contrary to it. For example, if someone thinks that he has sinned by stealing some property from somebody else, later he don't steal no more, but he give away his things, whatever he has, to the poor people. That's how he show his repentance.
Someone wanted to know as well, how does one become a member of your international organization?
You just let me serve you. If you would like to know God, that's how you can join us, just to pray for the world. You're not a member of anybody. You are only a member of God's kingdom. So I just want to show you how to meditate, how to know God, that's all. You're not a member of any kind. We normally don't have anything like a membership or anything. But we give you a little card, so whenever you come to see me in my private residencies, if you want to, you have priority to come in, ask question or meditate, whatever. That's it. There's no membership fee, no obligation. If you want to come, you come. You don't want to come, you don't come. Nobody will call you, bother you, or force you, or remind you of any kind. If you want to come, our house open. If you don't come, sayonara. Okay.
Okay, some of them couldn't help but notice your beautiful clothesline. Why do you promote buying makeup, fashion, and jewelry?
I like it.
Okay, good enough.
Life is so boring. I make it more beautiful. Just like you put flowers here for me, I put my make myself beautiful for you. Would you rather see an ugly woman sit here? Huh? Okay. Look like that? Wearing dirty and ragged clothes? You rather me represent God that way? Huh? Or you rather a person represent God in a clean and pure and nice looking? The second better or the first better?
Second,
right. But doesn't matter, it's okay. I can also wear nothing. If you prefer, I take this off right now, it's okay with me. I don't need any of these clothes, you are right. Shall I take them off? Oh, thank you. It's the same, you wear whatever you like, all right? I'm designing this for the purpose of earning money so that I can come to see you. I have to pay my ticket. I have to pay the people who work for you. That's why I don't take money from you. You see? And whatever left, we give to the poor people. We give it to the needy people. We also have given millions of dollars to Philippines because of my design and all that stuff. So can I continue my design and beautiful dress?
Yes.
Thank you.
Welcome. Okay, someone wanted to know, how many enlightened masters are on earth, and are you all working towards the same goal?
Yes, yes. How many? There are many, many. And they all work toward the same goal, to assist mankind to know God again.
So I guess that's the only time left for the question and answer. Yun na lang po yung oras natin para sa question and answer. Yung mga may tanong pa po, pwedeng ipadala na lang po sa mga staff o yung mga nasa reception, katulad po ni Sir. At sasagutin na lang po yun, pakalagay na lang po yung address nyo po at pangalan. So, pipilitin po ng grupo na mag-respond sa mga tanong po ninyo. Maraming salamat po sa lahat na nagpadala ng tanong. Thank you very much, Supreme Master Ching, for answering all the questions.
All right. Yes?
And also, ladies and gentlemen, pwede po bang requestan kayo pumunta ng happy birthday because on May 12, it is the birthday.
Oh, is it May 12 today?
Ching, so can we sing happy birthday to our Supreme Master Ching, right?
Yeah.
Because May 12 is very significant for her and Filipino people.
Oh,
and,
not yet.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, brother. You're so kind. Always love me so much. You and your wife. I remember the time I stayed in your house. You take care of me so much. I stayed in their house before. The whole family take care of me. When they first came to Philippines, they opened their house just like my house. That's how the Philippine people are. Thank you so much. Thank you.